Bonjour tout le monde. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm very pleased to be here today after a very successful nuclear security summit here in Washington. First, I'd like to thank my colleague and friend, the President of the United States, Barack Obama, for hosting this important meeting. Ce sommet a pour but de renforcer la sécurité nucléaire mondiale et de lutter contre le terrorisme nucléaire, l'une des plus grandes menaces à la sécurité internationale. Les leaders mondiaux ont le devoir de prendre toutes les mesures nécessaires pour empêcher le pire. Nuclear security is a priority for the Canadian government. We are committed to working with our allies and partners to prevent nuclear terrorism. Let me highlight a few points. First, countries like Canada have to continue to lead by example. Canada will continue to invest in its world-class nuclear security regime and share our expertise in this field with others. Second, diplomacy and advocacy in support of nuclear security will also be key. Canada will continue to support the International Atomic Energy Agency and the United Nations to advance the highest international standards of nuclear security. Third, states with the financial means to do so should deepen their investment in nuclear security worldwide. Canada remains fundamentally committed to doing so. In this regard, I am proud to announce that Canada will dedicate an additional $42 million in global partnership program funding over the next 2 years to improve nuclear and radiological security worldwide. These funds will be used to, for example, combat illicit trafficking through strengthening national capacities in the Americas and the Middle East, improve physical security at nuclear facilities, promote safe management and disposal of disused radioactive sources in countries and regions with identified needs, primarily in the Americas, and to support the International Atomic Energy Agency's Nuclear Security Fund. Nous sommes également heureux d'avoir co-dirigé, en partenariat avec l'Espagne et la République de Corée, l'élaboration d'une déclaration commune sur la mise en œuvre intégrale et universelle de la résolution 1540 du Conseil de sécurité des Nations Unies. Le Canada croit fermement que la résolution 1540 est un élément clé contre les armes de destruction massive terroriste. Cette résolution oblige les États membres de l'ONU à prendre des mesures concrètes pour empêcher que des armes de destruction massive et d'autres matières qui leur sont associées ne tombent pas entre de mauvaises mains. Le Canada co-dirige aussi l'élaboration d'une déclaration commune en collaboration avec le Royaume-Uni qui vise à offrir une formation accréditée complète aux praticiens du domaine de la sécurité nucléaire. During this summit, we have also discussed the threat of terrorist networks such as ISIL. As part of Canada's refocused strategy for support to the global coalition against ISIL and broader engagement in the region, we will allocate $51 million over 3 years to counterterrorism capacity building programming in the Middle East and North Africa. The funds will be drawn from the resources announced on February 8, 2016, when Canada articulated its refocused strategy for Iraq, Syria, Jordan, and Lebanon. Programming will focus on helping to stem the flow of foreign fighters and counter ISIL's financing and messaging. The funds will also support broader security activities in neighboring countries in order to reduce their vulnerability to ISIL infiltration. Canada has played a constructive role in negotiating the Nuclear Security Summit action plans aimed at strengthening the nuclear security architecture and sustaining the momentum of the post-summit agenda. To this end, we are proud to continue to play a leadership role in the field of nuclear and radiological security and to work with allies and partners to prevent nuclear terrorism. In the margins of this summit, I had the opportunity to meet face to face with a number of world leaders to discuss important bilateral issues. I had productive meetings with the President of Argentina, Mauricio Macri, the Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, the Prime Minister of Japan, Shinzo Abe, and the Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, David Cameron. During my time in Washington, I was also honored to speak before the U.S. Chamber of Commerce. Canada's first federal budget was just over a week ago, so it was a privilege to speak with this distinguished group about Canada's approach to strengthening our economy. Dans l'ensemble, ce fut un voyage incroyablement productif. Nous avons fait de grandes avancées aujourd'hui pour renforcer la sécurité nucléaire internationale et le Canada est fier de participer à cet important effort. Thank you. I look forward to your questions.